Good afternoon. A 20-year-old rider has died while competing in a motocross championship southeast of Melbourne. Gillian Lanturis is at the scene for us this afternoon. Jill, what happened?
Alicia, it's very quiet and eerie here now, but it was just before 11 o'clock this morning when a 20-year-old man from Ipswich in Queensland was competing in the MX2 race here in Wonthaggi. It's understood he took a fall when he was coming off a jump and was subsequently hit by another competitor. He was treated here at the scene with a severe head injury, but sadly he couldn't be saved. Now, this all unfolded in front of hundreds of spectators. Motorcycling Australia quickly cancelled the event and ushered everyone out. This event brings in the most elite motocross competitors across the country, so a very sad day for everyone involved. And Alicia, I do understand that both police and WorkSafe are investigating the death.
Okay, Gillian Lanturis, thank you. A 29-year-old man has died after being shot by police during a confrontation in Sydney southwest. Ruth Wynne-Williams is at the scene.
Just before nine this morning here in Sydney's southwest, police claim they were ambushed. A domestic violence call out to a family home, ending in the death of 29-year-old Hilal Baba. Police claim it was confronting. Here is what played out.
They were confronted by a 29-year-old Yaguna man from the address, brandishing two large knives. The individual tried to slash and stab the female officer. She lost her footing. She fell backwards. He continued the attack. His focus then was drawn to the male officer, who then deployed the service firearm. This is a frightening incident. On Sunday morning, you go to a job. It is a DV matter. They activated body worn, but they didn't expect to be confronted by such a vicious and intent act by an individual who was trying to kill them.
The 29-year-old was treated briefly here on the street. He was then taken to Liverpool Hospital, but he couldn't be revived, succumbing to those gunshots after being fired on by police. Neighbours say they heard repeated shots.
I heard like three fireworks of what I thought it was. And then next thing I hear, my neighbours screaming, "Oh my God, what have you done?"
I didn't expect that there'd be another police incident, but it seems to be becoming a bit more commonplace around here.
Hilal Baba's family claim the man had long been suffering serious issues with his mental health. A critical incident team is now looking into what happened.
The body of a missing paddleboarder has been found at the popular Listerfield Lake in Melbourne's southeast. Witnesses last saw the 38-year-old Clayton man yesterday afternoon before the alarm was raised and a major air and land search got underway.
It's very sad.
This is the roughest I've ever seen it.
There are lots of unseen hazards, snags, and currents are still very prevalent in those inland waterways.
The man's death is not being treated as suspicious. Well, 15 mine workers have spent the night trapped underground after a mine fire near Bendigo in Victoria. The blaze erupted around midnight, with workers extinguishing the flames before retreating into rescue bunkers. After making the site safe, specialist firefighters escorted the miners to the surface before sunrise. Thankfully, no one was injured, with the cause now under investigation. Tributes are pouring in for a Queensland teenager who was fatally struck by a ute seen being driven dangerously through the Brisbane suburbs. Kate Lamb reports.
Well, family and friends have spent the day grieving together here at the very spot where Jai Anderson's life was tragically cut short. They've been laying tributes, including flowers, a helmet and gloves for the 17-year-old who was riding a dirt bike when police say it was struck by a black Toyota Hilux ute that was being driven dangerously along Bourke Street around 8 last night. The ute's driver allegedly fleeing, leaving behind 17-year-old Jai, who died at the scene, while his pillion passenger, 19-year-old Ezekiel, suffered serious leg injuries and was rushed to the Princess Alexandra Hospital.
I rang the ambulance, 000, to ring, call the ambulance. My son was, trying to give him, revive him, and there was a few other people around. They stayed with him till the ambulance came.
The police helicopter tracked the suspect vehicle to Cairns Street at Logan Home, where officers arrested a 21-year-old Thornlands man. Detectives today scouring for CCTV and dash cam as they build their case, with the accused driver set to face Brisbane Magistrates Court tomorrow, charged with manslaughter, grievous bodily harm, and failed to remain at the scene.
Another week and another rate rise is on the horizon, with the Reserve Bank set to meet on Tuesday. The government and major economists are adamant the worst of inflation is behind us, and there is some good news on the way for young families. Political editor Charles Croucher has the story.
Parliament resumes here tomorrow, but before returning to Canberra, the Deputy Leader of the Opposition, Susan Lee, paid a visit to Anthony Albanese's backyard. This is in Marrickville. In the Prime Minister's seat, she visited a small business, one of the thousands that she says are struggling because of increased interest rates and decreased spending from the public because of the cost of living.
Small businesses, manufacturing businesses, people in communities are really, really struggling with the cost of living. And we've got a government that needs to spend more time focusing on their needs.
And that interest rate pinch will likely get worse on Tuesday when the Reserve Bank meet. There'll be big focus on cost of living over the coming weeks here at Parliament. They should see the Senate pass the expanded paid parental leave scheme. That'll see more Australians come into the scheme and be able to access it for longer. There are big fights over the National Reconstruction Fund, some $15 billion that will go in towards manufacturing and jobs here, as well as the safeguard mechanism that is looking to promote renewable energy and the use of cleaner energy amongst businesses. But there is also that focus still on the policy of superannuation that isn't going to be introduced until 2025, isn't coming into effect until 2025. Today, the opposition questioning just how many people it could impact in the future.
This policy, it's flawed. In some respects, it's reckless, and it will have a far bigger reach, much bigger reach, than Labor is pretending here.
His ridiculous and dishonest scare campaign falling down all around him under the weight of its own lies.
That debate will rage long into the future. In the meantime, around kitchen tables around Australia, making ends meet remains the biggest focus.
New South Wales Labor is promising to introduce a university scholarship program as it officially launched its state election campaign. If it wins at the polls on March 25, the party will give 2,000 nursing, midwifery and allied health students a $12,000 discount on their degrees if they work in the public system. Meanwhile, the Liberal Party is committing $1.2 billion for hospitals and critical health services. Mourners have gathered in Cairns in honour of Toya Cordingley, days after her accused killer was brought to Queensland after 4 years on the run. Toya's story has captured the hearts of the community, which is now awaiting the trial of Rasvinder Singh, charged with her murder.
In the end, I think a lot of it has, or most of it has come from the community, and I'm just glad for Toya and her family that we've all hung in together and we've done what we've done. She's an absolutely beautiful young girl. Very petite, very smart, loved animals, loved the family, loved the community.
Mr. Singh will face court next month.